Attention of our worship coming before you as a sweet-smelling incense that you will receive it as such. Bless it, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. Go ahead, guys. I want to just leave you with a little word this morning. Don't want to send you home without any. There's a scripture in 2 Samuel chapter 14. I've read over it many times, but reading through it this morning, it jumped out at me. And it says, "For we will surely die and become like water spilled on the ground, which cannot be gathered up again." Now listen to this next part, though. "Yet God does not take away a life, but God devises means so that his banished ones are not expelled from him." Think about that just for a second. God never one time devises a plan to destroy life.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
And when the circumstances of our life, whether by our choices or someone else's choices, where the things of life have caused us to become to a place that it seems as if we have been banished from the very presence of God, when it seems like things of life have caused us to go so far that there's no hope, there's no help, and there's no way back, and the enemy of your soul is whispering that one word that he loves to use over and over and over: unworthy, 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 until we feel as if we are driven completely away from the land of the kingdom of heaven, completely away from his face, till it seems as if we are completely driven from his eye. Listen. Yet God does not take away a life, but he devises means so that his banished ones are never expelled from him. So this morning I want to tell you, I don't care how bad it gets. I don't care how far you go. I don't care how dark the darkness is in your life. I don't care what enemy's plans have been devised against you. I don't care about the darkness.
Amen.
What I want to tell you is this. Our God was the one that said, "Let there be light." Before there was ever even light in existence, he was the God of the infinite black darkness. And no matter what darkness there is on your life or in your life, our God is still God in that darkness. And he sees you just as you are. And he sees you just where you are. And he sees just the circumstance you're in. And he has devised plans that you will never be expelled from him. I don't care what the enemy said to you. I don't care how banished you feel. I don't care how unworthy the enemy has convinced you you are. I don't care how low you think you are. There is never a low. There is never a darkness. There is never a place in banishment that your God is not with you. That his presence is not right there with you. That he has devised a plan to keep you in his eye. Listen to me. I preached a long time about Abba, 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 Abba. And I want you to know today, he is your Abba. He is your Father. He loves you beyond measure. He will never cast you away. And though the enemy has convinced you, banish.
Come on.
I will tell you today, he is a liar and the father of it. He's never told you the first truth, and he's not starting with this. If he's telling you you've been banished, gone too far, and the darkness is too deep, he is the father of lies. You know it's a lie because it's coming out of his mouth. The truth is this. The light came and pierced the darkness. And that light's name is Jesus Christ. He said, "I am the light of the world." Let me say it again. I don't care about how deep the darkness is. I don't care what the darkness is. I don't care what the title and the name of it is. And the enemy has convinced you that you are banished. You listen to me. Jesus Christ the righteous is the light that pierces that darkness. He has a plan for you. Thoughts of good and not of evil to bring you to an expected end. He has devised means whereby to bring his banished ones back to himself that you will never be expelled from him. And all you have to do is cry out upon Jesus. All you have to do is cry out upon Jesus. Accept him as your Savior. Call out upon him. Weep before him. You can cry out, "God, the darkness has overtaken me, and I feel as if I am devoured and there is nothing left. Father, I feel like I've been banished so far that you don't even know where I am. And if you will listen very closely, what you will hear is a still small voice whispering, I never left you. And I never forsaken you. I am here with you always, even unto the ends of the earth. So this morning I will ask you this. Will you submit to his light?
Come on.
I'll ask you, will you submit to that still small voice?
Amen.
And you might say, my life is so out of control, it's as if I don't even get to make my own decisions. The darkness makes the decisions for me and drags me from place to place to place. It's as if I am completely not even in control of my own life, and I don't know if I can do that. I don't know if I can call out of his name. I don't know if I can do it. Let me remind you this. In Isaiah chapter 61, he said, I came to break every yoke. I came to set the captive free. I came to break out of the prison. I know you feel in prison. I know you feel chained. I know you feel like there's no hope and no way out, but he is the hope. Woo! He is the way out. Today, everyone bow your head. If you're out there and the enemy has convinced you that you've been banished and driven from the presence of the King and he does not care for you, I will remind you it is a lie. Abba loves you beyond measure. Abba, Father, loves you beyond measure. And Jesus is your way. So with your head bowed right this minute, if you are that banished one, and the enemy has whispered to you how unworthy you are, and you've never accepted him as your Savior, right there where you're sitting, right this minute, I want you, with your head bowed, just do this. Begin to say, Jesus. Jesus. I'm here. Jesus. I'm here. Jesus. Come. Forgive me of my sins. Jesus, the darkness is too great and I can carry it no more. Forgive me. Call out upon his name. Ask him to forgive you. And instantaneously, that quick, he will cleanse you. He will write your name in the Lamb's Book of Life. If you will call out upon his name, if you will submit your heart and your life to him and call out upon him, he will save you and he will set you free. Right now, with your head bowed, I'm not asking you to stand up, raise your hand, do anything else. I'm just asking you right where you are, right this minute, you pray, right this minute, right now. Father, here I am. I'm lost. I'm undone. The darkness is overwhelming me. I need your light. I need to be saved. I need to be lifted up. He will do it right this minute. I'll give you just a moment. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, darkness, I command you to bow your knee. In the name of Jesus, you spirit of a lie, I command you to silence your voice. In the name of Jesus, for the chains of bondage, of addiction, of darkness, in the name of Jesus, I command you before your King, you will break. And you will release those souls trapped in darkness. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, free, free, free. Father, I praise you. Father, I praise you. Father, I praise you. If there's anybody out there now, and you've just done what I said, if there's anybody out there and you just did what I said, as a testimony, as a confession, a public confession, so that the enemy will know he has you no more. I just want you to stand up. Anybody? I see you standing. Anybody? Yes, yes, yes. Father, I praise you. Father, I praise you. Father, I praise you. Those of you standing, just lift your hands right now. Father, in the name of Jesus. these that are standing this moment to say, I am called out upon the name of Jesus, and I know my darkness is broken. Father, I pray right now that your anointing would be upon them, that you will wrap your arms of love around them, that they would leave this place knowing that they know, that they know, that they know, that they know, that, they know that their name's written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Right this minute on Facebook, if you listen to the words that I said, if you heard the voice of Jesus calling, then you sent a message on that Facebook as a testimony. Jesus saved me today. Jesus saved me today. Father, I praise you. Father, I praise you. Glory. Sister Christy's going to come and make a couple of announcements. You got them there handy. And the last thing I want to say is this. Who in the world gets to have this much fun? Only the children of the living King get to enjoy this. Thank you so much for being here today. Thank you for being sensitive to the move of the Spirit. God bless you.
Better than the Razorbacks.
Better than the Razorbacks. That's exactly right.
Oh my goodness. I don't even know what I look like up here, but I don't even care. I know I've got wet.
Come on,
girl. I've lost my necklace. I've got my shoes. Somebody brought them to me, but I'm going to tell you what. I'll testify before I give these announcements. Now I've got a word for you, Brother Luke. You've been in neutral. And the Lord shifted you in drive today. And he said, no longer will you go in reverse ever again. Let's clean the toilets. Let's start in the nursery. Let's take up the offering. We're a body of Christ. used as a body of Christ for him. Last thing, we will have church tonight at 6 o'clock. And oh my, I've got a message, but just excited about what's going to happen. Brother Luke's in drive. We're going to tell him where he's going to take us tonight. And I know it's going to be good, sir. So stand with me, and I'm going to pray over you. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for what you've done in this place this morning, Lord. Your presence is real and mighty and glorious. And we are grateful, Lord, for your presence, Lord. I pray, Lord, that you would take us home safely, that you would bring us back tonight, Lord, to worship you in spirit and in truth, Lord. And we will be grateful, and we will be praising your name all the way and all the way back tonight. For we love you, and we give you praise. In Jesus' name, the church said,